you. And just letting yourself kind of settle into your breath, settle into your body. And, you know, just giving yourself a moment to be here in this room. And as we do start to come into movement together in a few moments, you know, honoring what you need on this particular day. And if you're feeling more energetic, or maybe you're not feeling energetic, but you want to be, and so you want to kind of shake off some of that static energy, that's kind of where I'm at, so I'm not sure if I'll be successful, but just letting yourself go totally at your own pace. And I know all of you have practiced with me before, so I hope you know I'm totally sincere when I say, you know, whatever you do is right. So just feel good about doing something different if you prefer, letting yourself explore something that might challenge you, or at the same time, something that just might be more restful. You can lay on the floor for the next 70 minutes or so, and you're still doing your practice. You showed up, that's all that counts. And then from here, just start to let yourself walk your arms off to one side of your mat. And it doesn't really matter which side first, just feeling that stretch, that lengthening through your side waist. You have any tension in your shoulders, maybe kind of pressing and pulling with your hands, seeing where you can get a little bit more room. And then just nice and easy, you can let yourself come down the center. And maybe just take a moment there and act like you're trying to pull the hands towards you. By pushing them into the mat, feel your shoulder blades retract down your back. And then just start to walk yourself up and over to the opposite side. And again, you might play with pushing and pulling through your hands, just seeing how that affects things. It's funny, I was working with a couple of my friends on Friday, and we were trying, sadly, to do some pull-ups. I used to be decent at pull-ups, but I am not right now at all. I hurt so much. Come back down the center. I think I got one good one in, like, three sort of ones. And then let yourself from here start to shift forward, just coming towards the shape of hands and knees, and readjust your knees so you feel supported, and hips are stacking over the knees, shoulders over the wrists, and then you start to let yourself go back and forth through a few rounds of cat and cow. And if you start to feel like a particular shape is really feeling good in your body, take a moment to pause there. You might have a little wiggle of your hips, your shoulders. I like to bring in a little bit more of the serpentine type movement with it. But just do what feels authentic for you. A little shake out of the head, perhaps. What can be kind of nice is it's just an opportunity to kind of check out what's going on in your body by starting to move your joints around, move your body parts around, and, you know, how are things feeling? And then the next time you're in more of a neutral spot, press down into your right hand, just take the left arm up to the sky. Left arm comes underneath the right, just coming in to threading the needle. And then you choose, either stay with your shoulder just on the floor, just as you are, or extend your right foot out towards your left hand. I like to bring my hand behind my back or press it into the floor, just try to lengthen the right side of your body a little bit more. Your eyes can totally be closed here as long as it doesn't make you dizzy. And then when you feel ready, bring your right hand down, take your left arm up to the sky. Now take your left arm down. Now we're going to take the right arm up. Bring the right arm underneath the left. So with your leg extended, it's probably going to limit your range of motion a little bit. At least I know it does for me. Give it another breath or two where you are. And then when you're ready, you can press into your left hand. Take the right arm up to the sky. Then just bring both hands down to the mat. Sit back like you're in a half child's pose for a moment. If it's too much on your right hamstring, just soften your knee a little bit. And then like you're starting to slide back up to hands and knees, but then bring your left hand out in line with your left hip. And then just open the right arm. So it's a great big sideways opening. But it doesn't matter, you're fine. And then when you inhale, pick up the right leg, swing it behind you, bringing your right hand down to the mat. Extend your left arm forward. And then just coil it, elbow to meet the knee, so just waking up the belly a little bit. Extend it back out long. Coil in, elbow to meet the knee. Extend it back out long. One more time, coil in, and now that your right foot's maybe a little closer, maybe catching it with your hand, using the foot to lift your chest. Both hands can be on the ground if that's better. You can do it that way too, go for it. Give it another breath. Now on the exhale, let both hands, both shins come down. Walk your hands down, keeping your hips high unless that bothers your shoulders. Just coming into puppy pose. And then you're going to roll forward, come all the way out to your belly. We'll do the other leg in a moment, so don't worry. Take your right arm out in line with your right shoulder. Sorry, I know I do this every class, but it's my favorite. And then turn your palm to face the sky. And then roll your chest open. Just letting yourself kind of sink into it. Any variations you'd like to add to it. And then just ease your way back down to your belly. Slide the right hand in, the left arm out. Flip your palm to face the sky and just rolling yourself open once again. Try to let your head be heavy to the floor if you can. And then just nice and easy, come back around towards your belly. Slide both hands under your shoulders. Take down dog just for a moment, just to get yourself away from the ground, lengthen your legs, hang your head. And then from there, let yourself shift forward, lower down the shins. And then just start to let yourself come back into your rounds of cat and cat. Readjusting your hands under the shoulders as you need and letting yourself kind of play with the distance of your knees from each other or underneath your hips. The next time you round your spine to the sky, give yourself a moment there just to pause. Chin towards the chest, really pressing the floor away. And then let yourself come into a neutral spine, press into your left hand, right arm up to the sky. And then let the right arm come underneath the left, head and shoulder coming down. And then if you'd like to, extend the left foot out towards your right hand. You can either press into your left hand or reach it up to the sky. Sometimes I'll use it to actually press my left thigh away. Just trying to find more length in the side body. And then when you're ready to unwind, left hand can come down, right arm to the sky. And then let your right hand come down, take the left arm up to the sky. Again, this might feel a little bit more sticky. Left arm underneath the right, head and shoulder coming down. If you're feeling a lot of pressure in your hamstring or your knee, just soften it a little bit. And then here, press down into your right hand. Left arm is up to the sky. And then just exhale, sit back towards your right heel and let your head just kind of drop down towards the mat. And then like you're starting to slide forward to hands and knees, but then take your right arm on the line of your right hip. Left arm can sweep up and overhead or however feels good for you. It doesn't matter. You can do whatever you want. And then pick up your left leg. Swing it behind you. Left hand down. Right arm reaches forward. And then pull in an elbow to meet the knee. And then just extend and lengthen. Elbow to meet the knee. Extend and lengthen. One more time, and then maybe while it's closer, reaching back towards your heel, letting yourself press the heel into the hand and lift your heart to the sky. Soften along your jaw. And then just exhale, both shins, both hands, down to the mat. Once again, puppy pose, just letting yourself roll down toward your belly. Now slide all the way forward towards your belly. If you're right at the edge of the mat, you might want to slide back just a little bit so your elbows are on your mat. So walk your arms forward, and then all you do is bend your elbows, and you kind of pick them up, walk a little further away. Bring your arms as close together as you can get them comfortably, and then you can let your head drop down. Now, if you want deeper, what it does is it gets into one shoulder more than the other. Take one arm on top, an eagle, it doesn't matter which one, but we're doing both. And then let yourself sink in. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's a little too intense, so it's up to you. If you want, you can always turn your head to the side so you don't feel like you're squashing your face on your arms. Soften your jaw. And then when you switch the arms, try to pick up your head enough that you're not kind of clunking your elbows around too much on the ground. You might even want to open the arms up for a second, and then just let the opposite arm come up on top. If your elbows won't move away because your mat's too sticky, you can always move your body away from your elbows instead. Sink in, trying to let yourself soften. Eyes can close, jaw can relax. And then when you're ready to hear, you can start to unwind the arms. Just give yourself a moment just to kind of splat on the ground, maybe turn your head to the side. And then as it feels right for you, slide your hands under your shoulders, and then just start to press yourself up and back, downward facing dog, or dolphin if you'd rather get in your forearms. And then just take a moment in this shape. Just to kind of let yourself explore what feels good. It might be just a gentle sway of your hips from side to side, a shaking down of your head. I usually like to play a little bit with bending the arms and kind of lengthening again, feeling that subtle lift up through your belly. And Nicole, I'm sorry, I was telling Marie before you got here, if I'm very monotone today, I didn't sleep very well last night, so my dog had me up a lot. Even another breath. And then just nice and easy, start to let your feet come on up towards your hands. Take a moment once you get there, just to pause. You can keep your feet kind of on the wider side. And then either opposite elbows, or just let your hands drape down towards the ground. You might even want to use one or both of your hands to lengthen out your neck. Just giving yourself some space to kind of explore. Like for me personally right now, my hamstrings are kind of tight, so this feels good just to let my belly and chest kind of rest on my thighs, softening one knee and then the other. Maybe for you, it's more of your neck or your shoulders. So emphasizing where you need it. And then here, we'll just start to move to create some more heat, create some more space. So either rolling spine or long spine. So you start to ease your way up to standing. Draw the arms up nice and high to the sky when you get there. Hold on to the right wrist. Just climb up and over towards the left. Just letting your head just rest on your arm if you like. And come back up through the center. Switch up and over to the opposite side. And then as you come to the center, just let your hands scoop around to your low back. Fingers can face up or down, but think tailbone down, heart high, lifting the heart, squeezing your shoulders towards each other. And then when you fold, fold here, just let your hands slide right down the back of your legs and giving yourself a little massage on the way down. Inhale, take a halfway lift. Now on the exhale, just step back towards a high plank. And then just nice and easy, lower yourself all the way down towards your belly. Take your arms so they're slightly out to the side, elbows are bent, and then you can let your head stay down. My head's just up so you can hear me. See if you can pick up your elbows and your hands. And then play a little bit with lifting the elbows slightly higher than your hands, and then trying to lift your hands a little higher than the elbows, which probably won't work that great. And then see if you can squeeze everything up. Try to squeeze between the shoulder blades. I like to try to look down just to keep my neck kind of neutral. Then press into your feet, press into your legs so you can lift the chest a little bit higher. And then here, just squeeze the elbows down by your body. And then as long as your back's okay, sweep the arms forward. If it's too much to fully extend them, don't. Pull down, think of it like you were doing a lat pull at the gym. And then extend the arms forward. One more time, pull back. Now this time, flip your palms to face the ground. Let your palms act as you're kind of skimming across the surface of the mat, palms to the sky. Lift the heart a little higher. Good. Now turn your palms to face down towards the ground. Scoop them forward so they're right underneath your shoulders. Press down, and then just come on into cobra. Letting yourself really squeeze your legs, shoulders back for you. Yes. And then from there, you can curl the toes under and go to down dog, or if you'd rather take a moment to lower down, and then reset, and then just come up and back. Downward facing dog. Take a moment to bring your feet a little wider than normal. And if your heels aren't touching, shorten your stance a bit. And then just press into your right hand. Take your left hand towards your right foot. And if it doesn't reach your foot, just reach underneath your arm and then look underneath your arm. And then just come back to the center. Left hand can touch down, right hand towards the left foot, or just underneath the left arm if the foot's not within reach. And then just bring both hands forward. Now here is walk your hands to your feet so you're at the back of the mat. Hooking your big toes with your fingers. Take a halfway lift, so lengthen the heart forward. And then just exhale, bend the elbows, drop yourself in. And slide your shoulders away from your ears. One more time, lengthen out the spine. And then exhale, just sink in. We're gonna come all the way to standing and release the feet. Swipe all the way up tall. Then just exhale, let your hands drop down, bend your knees a little bit, let your hands land on your thighs, and then kind of roll your spine back up like you're doing cat's breath, and then pull your heart forward like you're doing cat. So you're just rolling the spine back and forth, kind of old school aerobic style. And then inhaling, yeah, draw your heart forward. One more time, let yourself roll the spine up. Now this time when we come down, we're going to keep letting the hands slide all the way down the legs and walk them forward. Let your shins come down, walk your arms forward, coming into puppy pose. So just letting yourself kind of sink the head and the heart. Now this time when we come forward, we're going to come to forearm plank. So slide forward again. You might want to make sure your elbows are on your mat. I prefer to clasp my hands, but it's up to you. Curl the toes under, that's it. Tuck your tailbone under a little bit. The other way. Yes, that, perfect, good, good, good. Puff up between the shoulders, that's it, nice strong legs. Kind of feel that wrapping in of your belly, one more breath here. And then just nice and easy, lift your hips, your thighs, your belly's lower down. Either press into the Sphinx variation of Cobra, or if you would like to slide your hands back for Cobra, or even Up Dog, you're welcome to. Good, and then exhale all the way back, downward facing dog. Take your right leg up to the sky, and then you open the hip. But then just make a great big circle with that right leg. And you can interpret that however you want. The same thing as you're trying to get a little juice going in the joint. And then after a couple of circles in one direction, try the other way too, just so that way you have some space to unwind it. Then think about lengthening the leg. Try to close your hip for a moment. So roll the toes more towards the ground. Then kind of slow motion, pull the knee into your belly. Start to shift forward to plank. Really try to pull the knee up and in towards your chest. Look between your fingers and then just step that right foot forward. Ground your left heel and come on into warrior one. Good, next. Then here it is, exhale. Let the arms press back, chest can sink. Inhale, sweep back up. This time when the arms press back, keep them there for a moment. Turn your palms to face your body and then just bend your elbows. Squeeze your elbows towards each other so your hands will go kind of wide. You can stay like that if that's enough activation. Or if you want, clasp your hands and then try to draw the knuckles down your back. We're not going to go any lower right now with the upper body, so think more crown of the head to the nose. Give it a breath where you are. Now from here, just let your hands release. You can sweep back up to the sky. Let your hands come to your hips. Now you start to lengthen the right leg, but try not to lock your knee. Good. And then just sink back in. Good. And then lengthen. Good. Sink back in. One more time, lengthen, and then here, lean back a little bit, like you're trying to stretch your belly, and then just start to let yourself fold, and you might decide to pause halfway with your hands towards your thighs, maybe your hands are coming to the ground or down towards your palms, but think about trying to draw the left hip forward, the right hip back a bit, yeah, and think down dog tilt to your tailbone, so your butt's kind of sticking up in the sky, but soften your jaw, both of y'all sticking butt in the air. So then try this because if I think if both of you just came up a smidge higher, you'll be able to push back a little bit. You both really good this time. Good, good, good. And you're just going to feel a deeper stretch. So now from here, we're going to shift towards the shape of standing split. Now you might step your foot in a little bit, give yourself some room, floating the left leg up to the sky. Just giving yourself a moment to pause. Now if you want to play, you can pick up your hands or you can kind of play with moving the leg in the air a little bit. Good, very nice. Now here, just for a moment, lower down your left foot. Just inhale, come to standing just for a second. So arms up and then hands down. So I'm just gonna teach you how to chop each other off with a standing split. Doesn't mean you have to do it, but I wanna make sure. It's a similar concept when we do it in down dog, that the leg that's on the ground hits the ground first. Then somebody karate chop it out from underneath. I'll show you what I mean. So you'll be in standing split with the left leg up in the air. If you don't want to jump, you'll just step back. If you want to jump, right foot hits first, and you just kind of push it back. And then you lower it and come back. It's very exciting for my way, isn't it? So here, pull forward. Yeah, take the left leg up to the sky. You do not have to jump if you don't want to. If you don't want to, just step. But if you want to jump, right foot chaturanga, swoop it back. Yes, that was it, ladies. Perfect. And then let yourself inhale. I don't know what you did, Jen, but I hope it was fun. And then all the way up and back. Down, facing down. Press up to your right foot, take the left leg up to the sky. Bend the knee, open the hip. And again, just take a second, roll the hip out. A couple circles go in one direction, perhaps, and then the other. Maybe we can emphasize more of rolling the toes, the ankles, and really the juicy stuff. And then extend your leg behind you and then try to close your hips so you can feel the difference. Then coil the left knee up and into your belly really strong. Look up between your thumbs. And then step the left foot forward. You always hop it with your hands. Warrior one. Round the back heel. And then arms reach. Good. Next. And here, lay your arms press back. Inhale, sweep up to the sky. Arms press back. This time, pause there for a second. Palms are facing towards you. Bend the elbows if you're trying to chicken wing your elbows towards each other. And then either just stay like that or clasp the hands behind you. Think of trying to shoot your chest forward, lengthening out your spine. Good, really nice. Give another breath where you are. Now as your inhale comes, come up. You can lengthen your left leg. Then exhale as you yourself sink back into the knee. Now your arms can stay higher, come to your hips many times. Left leg long. And then sink in. Left leg long. Here I would go to your hips if they're not already. Pull your heart forward. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Think tailbone back. Heart forward. And then eventually hands might come down to the ground, to the blocks, to your thigh. And if you want, play with it a little bit. See what happens when you think of down dog, tilt to the tailbone to the sky. Or if you pull the pubic bone and curl it under, notice where you have more or less sensation. And probably where it feels more stable. It's more than likely when you bust to the sky. Now when you're ready here, we're going to shift to standing split. You either move the hands forward or maybe try to do it without using your hands and just kind of let yourself float up. Just be careful if you jump to chaturanga if the hands are on the blocks that they're probably at the lowest point. Now, if you don't want to jump, you're just going to step back, either foot first, but if you're jumping back, left foot hits the ground first. So give a little swoop back. Yeah, that is it. Inhale, lift your chest, and then exhale, take it back. Now we're facing up. Walk your hands back to your feet, so you're at the back of the mat. Separate your feet decent wide, and then if you'd like, stand on your hands, or just press the back of your hands into the ground if you'd like to stretch them out. Get a little shake out of your head. So I heard this morning on the news that Jennifer Lopez's second album, Little Man Jenny from the Block, and like all the kind of songs she was kind of famous for, is 20 years old. I'm like, what? How is that possible? And then pull your heart forward. And then exhale, just let yourself sink in. And then release your hands out from underneath your feet. Come all the way up to standing, sweeping it up to the sky. And then exhale, let your hands just come down and in towards the mat. So we're going to do a little cat-cow thing again. Inhale, sweep up. Hands towards your legs, and just think heart forward, kind of sinking in. Now just round your spine. And you can keep your hands on the legs or sweep them up. It's totally up to you. Then pull the heart forward. So just try to open up the chest and shoulders a little more. Rolling up. This time we're going to roll all the way down. So just keep letting your hands slide down the legs. You can forward fully. Walk your hands up. Lower down your shins. Walk your arms forward. Coming into puppy pose. Child's pose works too. Excuse me. Child's pose. Then from here, let yourself slide forward. Coming down towards that forearm plank. So think of cat's breath to your shoulders, kind of round your spine and tuck your tailbone under. Yes, you want the feet closer together, makes it more challenging. Now here, try to let your feet slide backwards a little bit on your mat so your shoulders are behind your elbows. Good, pull that belly up and in. Yeah, there you go. Good, and then if you want to challenge yourself more, slide your feet back a little further. Don't worry, the worst thing that'll happen is you end up on your stomach. Give it a breath. Good. And then easy, just lower it down, pause for a second. Either come onto your hands or stay on your forearms, coming into cobra, or if you prefer up dog, just lifting the hips and thighs all the way up. Good, very nice, ladies. And then from here, downward facing dog, just pressing yourself up on the mat. Take your right leg up towards the sky. Now we're stepping into warrior two, but try not to step forward too quickly. So think knee to your belly. Roll yourself forward for that lift up through the core, and then step your foot between your hands. Ground the left heel, and then just come on into warrior two. Good. Now here, let your hands come to the center as you kind of coil out of your leg stump, and then just sink back in. Keep dialing your right knee open. Good. Inhale, coil up. Sink in. Now this time, stay low. Reach the right arm to the sky, reversing your warrior. And then just come on up and over side angle. Now just let your left shoulder roll down, turn to face the long edge of your mat, and bend your back knee. And then just bend your front knee. Now look over the right shoulder, I'll face the same way too. Come on into warrior one, just facing over your right foot, facing towards the windows, the front of the room. Draw the arms up high. Now let the arms kind of sweep back like we did the last time. Now you can either just let your hands rest in your low back, or if you want to clasp them, you're welcome to. Roll up on the ball of the left foot, and then just see if you can shift towards warrior three. Now from there, bend the left knee. Try to keep the hip closed, but push the foot to the ceiling. So decent activation in your glute and your hamstring. Lift your heart a little higher. Now pull the left knee into your belly, and you can move your arms. Cross your left ankle over your right thigh, and then just sit into a figure four. Here, if you want to bring the hands to the heart or in front of your shin, you're more than welcome to. Just trying to stay steady on that right foot. Now from here, just inhale, let yourself draw up. Reach the left foot behind you. Now let the left toes come down to the mat. Inhale, lengthen it up. Now we're going to fold over this long right leg so hands can come to your hips. And then just sink in, just coming into pyramid. Now here, you want to start letting your chest drop a little bit lower, letting yourself maybe not be quite as long in your low back. Just let it be in a place that you're getting good sensation in your hamstring without strain. Now, if you don't like the standing split, you're more than welcome to let it go. But if you want to, soften into the right knee. Take the left leg up to the sky. Now, even if it's only for a second, try to lift up your chest a little bit and see if you can take one hand or move both hands towards your heart. You'll put them down if you need them. Now, if you don't want to jump to chaturanga, just step back left and right. If you want to jump, it's right foot coming back first. And you can just bend those elbows so you have a little cushion. Inhale, heart lifts, and then up and back. Downward facing dog. Very nice job, ladies. On the inhale, take your left leg and reach up to the sky. Now first, feel free to open the hip. But before you step to warrior two, think about really pulling the knee up and into your belly. Look between your hands, and then step forward, warrior two. Draw yourself up. Good. Now here is coil the hands in towards the heart, so you're lengthening the left leg some. And then as you sink in, try to keep really engaged to your legs. Good. Inhale, coiling up. Exhale. Sinking in. Now this time, stay low. Just reverse your warrior. You might even take a little micro bend in your back knee. And then come on up and over. Side angle. Again, not staying terribly long, but still in that sideways opening. Then roll your right shoulder down. Just pivot and let yourself turn and bend your back knee. And then bend your front knee. Now look at your left leg that's laid towards the windows, turn all the way to the front of the mat. Come on into warrior one. And you probably need to readjust your feet a little bit. Now let the arms come down beside you. I like hands to go back just so I can feel where my hips are, but you can clasp the hands whatever you prefer. Roll up on the ball of the right foot. Maybe even step it in a little bit first. And then try to find a moment in warrior three. Bend the knee, but try to keep your hip closed, so it's more about the glute and hamstring engagement than mobility. Then pull the right knee up and into your belly. Cross over your left thigh. Sink into the figure four. Feel free to change your hands however you want to. Now just try to stay as controlled as you can. Don't worry, if you fall, you fall. Unwind the right leg. Start to reach it back, and now you're going to lengthen both legs. Arms might reach the sky at first. But then the hands can come to the hips and just let yourself start to fold over your long left leg. Just taking a moment in the pyramid shape. Now from here, as you shift the standing split, you can choose whether or not you're using your hands. So shift the weight forward a little bit, floating the right leg up to the sky. Maybe you just try to bring the hands to the heart. I usually find if I at least bend my knees a little bit, it helps. That's it, yes, good. And then either step, or if you want to jump to chaturanga, left foot goes first. It's totally up to you. Yes, there it is. Excellent. Inhale, you can lift your heart. And then eventually up and back, downward facing dog. Yeah. And then from here, let yourself lower down the shins. Bring your forearms down to the mat. Now, just interlace your hands, just so you have something to really push into. And just bring your elbows so they're under your shoulders, so not too wide. Good. Now curl your toes under and lift your hips. Now, if your head's really close to the floor, you can take a little bit of a push away and maybe bend your knees a little bit more. And for this particular moment, just let your head hang kind of neutral, just down towards the left. Now, if you want to get a little bit more into your hamstring, start to walk your feet a bit closer. Wider left to right is going to be more forgiving. Push the ground away. I'd rather your knees were bent and your chest was pressing back than the other way around. Give another breath there.
And then just nice and easy, you can step your feet back a little bit just so it'll feel more comfortable to release. And hold the shins for a moment. You might just sit back for a second. You can either sit to child's pose or sit up to let your arms release if you want to. Good. Now from here, we're going to be doing that in down dog, or we're going to be picking up a leg to the sky. Now you've already been jumping a little bit. I know you've jumped a lot. I know you're a little bit newer to the jumping. And that's okay. That's okay. But what I want you to think about is looking forward. Your feet further away from your hands, you won't get as high up. If you're starting to feel more brave, walk your feet in a little bit and lift and then gaze forward and just take a couple little jumps. And if you get nervous, just bend both your legs. That'll make it so your legs don't feel as heavy to pull you either direction. And as long as you don't kick a lot of the pusios, you're fine. So downward facing dog, please. Starting regular down dog. So even if you do want to bring the feet closer, just so you can see where you are today with it, lift whatever leg you feel more comfortable about. Yep. And then just look forward. Take a couple of jumps. And they can be tiny, tiny. Yep, that's it. Good. Really nice. Keep looking forward. Yeah, it just makes a difference. Good. Nice. And then try the other leg. We all have a leg we like better. That's why I didn't say it, because I knew you both people what you like better. I did too. Good. Up. Ground your hands from your fingertips to your bricks.
Yes.
Oh, awesome. That was it. I know, it's scary. When you get used
And then just eventually downward facing dog.
I'm so excited to zoom because you can't see. And then the inhale, take the hands laid on this side.
Set your right foot forward, warrior two. Jen, I hope you're having fun too. Let yourself sink in. Now here, keeping it simple, reverse your warrior. Start to lengthen your right leg. Now just shift your body back and come on into triangle. So right hand's coming down, left arm floating to the sky. Now if you'd rather stay here, you're welcome to stay. Or maybe the left hand comes to your low back or to your hip and you look down. Maybe you grab a block, letting yourself slide towards the shape of half moon. Now you can bend the right knee, excuse me, the left knee. Reach back for it with your left hand if you wish. Maybe you just want to play with trying to pick your right hand up. But try to keep your chest facing the side of the room rather than shifting to the floor. Good. And as calm as possible, let your left foot start to come back down. Inhale, come up, you can reverse your warrior. Now coming into side angle bars, we can also, but this time we're going to stay for a moment. So right arm is down, left arm extends. And then it's totally your choice if you want to wrap the left arm behind you. Some of you might want to bring the right hand down closer to the ground, either on a block or on your leg. But try to roll your chest open. And really feel the strong activation of your left leg. That's the back leg. The right leg can't help but be involved. Good. Give it one more breath where you are. Then when you are ready, you can inhale. Pull back to warrior two. Try to stay in it for a second. Okay, a little work for your leg. And then exhale the hands down, turn your toes in, bend your back knee, and I'm doing the opposite just in case you can see me, and then bend your front knee. Now I'll face the same way again, turn over your right leg, so all the way to the windows, warrior one. And you might notice I jumped my left foot off to the left a little. You need some more space. Now this time, take your right hand to right hip, left arm extends, you might want your block. Reach your left hand. And then just letting your left hand come down to the inside of your right foot. So coming into revolve triangle. Then the right hand, if you want to keep it more casual today, right hand to right hip. If you want a little more juice, right arm up to the sky. It's totally up to you. Root might be your two. Now here, right hand to right hip. It's about to get worse. Look down. Slide your left hand forward. Try to float your left leg. Now either stay like that or try to roll your right chest to the sky. So it's revolved half moon. And it's more challenging because you're trying to twist while your hips are closed and you're balancing. And there's way too much happening at one time. Give it a breath there. Now here, just let yourself bring the left toes back down to the mat. Bring your hands down to the mat and just lengthen your right leg. Just hold it. Now here comes the standing split. So you can shift your weight forward. Take your left leg up to the sky. Maybe you play with floating the hands, maybe you don't. And then again, if you're getting tired of jumping, don't feel like you have to whatsoever. But if you want, this time right foot's going to chaturanga first. Don't forget to bend the elbows. So maybe taking a hop and then chaturanga. Bend those elbows. Yes, that was it. And then eventually the downward facing dog. I know, it totally freaks you out. And then up and back, downward facing dog. Now look forward, set yourself and tiptoe your feet up towards your hands. Take a moment just to sink in. Come all the way up to stand. And then exhale. And come on into the heart. We started from the top of the mat last time. So inhale, reach up. So there's two more jumps if that makes any difference at all. Let yourself fold in. Left foot staying down, right leg is going up high to the sky. And then from here, again, if you just want to step back, or ground down, then handstand, chaturanga. Just bend those elbows. Look forward, Yes, bend those elbows. That was so good, I know. And then let yourself come up and back, downward facing. Awesome job. Left leg will lift up to the sky. And when you are ready, left foot comes through, warrior two. Just open it up wide. So we're keeping this part a little bit more simple since we're getting fancy on the jumps. So reverse your warrior, let yourself start to lengthen out. And then when you're ready, lengthen your left leg, and then just start to head towards the shape of trigonasana, triangle pose. Right arm can come to the sky, or you can keep it behind you. I tend to go behind me just because it's easier for the transition to half moon. That's your choice. Now, if you are doing half moon, I would look down. That just helps to make the transition more comfortable. Slide your right foot in a little bit, And then start to see if you can float that right leg. You might bend the knee and try to catch the foot, or you might try to pick the left hand off the floor. You could try to do both. Honestly, my biggest challenge is trying to keep my left foot straight. It always just wants to turn in. Yeah. And then as calm as can be, right foot's gonna come on back down. And kind of draw yourself back to warrior two. Good. Now, Parasarkonasana, side angle. Letting yourself come on in, right arm can sweep. If you want to bring it behind you or bind in any way, or maybe the left hand sliding lower down your left leg. But think about trying to engage your right leg. The left leg can't help but be part of it. Can you wrap the muscle around the bone on your back leg too? Soften your jaw, gaze can be higher or lower. Now try to keep the left knee bent just for a second. Now I'm going to get this straight in a minute. Inhale, pull yourself back to warrior two, so I'm going to get a little bit more fire. Good. Then exhale, let the hands come down, shift, bend your back leg. And then bend your front leg. And then just look over your left foot of the windows, turning to the front of the mat, coming towards that warrior one shape at first. But then start to take the hands to the hips, lengthening the left leg, right arm's going to reach. Extend, 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 coming into revolve triangle. So right hand down. You might just try to roll the left shoulder up if you want. Eventually the left arm might come to the sky. Good. Now the main reason we bring the hand down is it just makes the balance transition easier. If you want to keep the left arm up while you do it, you could. But I would look down, soften it to the left knee, and try to float the right leg behind you. And this pose is really kind of awful. Because you're trying to balance, you're trying to close your hips, you're trying to open your heart, you're trying to open your shoulders. There's a lot happening at once. And then when you are ready, you can just let your right foot come back down. Lengthen your left leg, and just take a second just to fold over your long left leg. So it's the last standing split that's coming. So feel free to be as enthusiastic or as casual as you want about it. So soften into your left knee. Hands might move forward as the right leg reaches up to the sky. And then your choice, you can step, hop, float, chaturanga, bend those elbows. Yes, that was it, just keep wrapping those elbows in. And then from down dog, you'll actually come through to sit. How are you feeling? Okay. So since you guys have blocks, grab both of your blocks and put them right beside your body. And Jen, if you don't have blocks, you can also do it on your fist or just on the pick up your bum. So try to make sure they're right up against you. Yeah. So now all I want you to do from here is bend your knees, place your feet on the floor. Now, what you're going to try to do is pick up your bum, but not straight up, up and back. So you're going to actually push into your feet to help make that happen. Yep. So then up and back. Good. Yeah, that's it. Good, good, good. And then lower it back down. So let's try that again. So push down and up. Yup. Good. And then lower it down. Now from here, take your right leg. Pull it up. Good. Now just for simplicity's sake, this is easier on the hip. Take your right, ankle over your left thigh. Try to make sure your ankle bone's not jamming. Okay. Now bend your left knee, goes left on the floor. Hands on the bottom. Get real close to your hips, right up against your hips. Yep, now push up and back. Good. And then lower it down. Excellent. Get that right leg again. Let's wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Now, two different ways. This is better if your hip isn't as open. This is just better if you can get your arm underneath your leg. Yep, and we're on the block. You know what's going to happen, right? Yep, that's it, Maria. You can still use your left leg to help you. You're right, you're doing exactly right. Put your hand down. Yep. And now we're gonna roll up. Yeah! Nice! And then bring it down. Here's one last thing. We got it. Now, keep your arm underneath here. Don't worry about being able to touch anything. Just pick up your left leg. See if you cross your hands. Yep, yep. Good, good, good. Okay, put it down. So now, the full pieces, you pick it up, put it across your ankles. That's it, right across them. Push them out of the side. Keep. You're doing it. Yes! And then lower it down. Awesome job! Of course, now the left leg is
Let yourself unwind maybe the middle height, not super high. And then bring your feet into bound ankle, Baddha Konasana, and let your knees drop over. It's going to be a little bit of a deeper stretch for your inner thighs, and it will hopefully help relax your low back. If it's too much having your legs in this position, you can just straighten your legs out. We're going to anyway, so if you need to sooner than I say, don't hesitate to do it. You might even just let your hands rest on your hips or on your belly, or the floor, if that's more comfortable. And then rather than just letting your legs slide up to straight, if you're happy here, stay where you are, use your hands to bring your knees up towards each other. We're going to actually take the legs up to the sky. So just let the legs go straight up. This is a supported shoulder stand. What's nice about this is it's very little to no pressure in the neck and shoulders if you ever do feel compression when you do feel your shoulder stand or lap. And then from here, you can let yourself bring the legs back down, and you might just let them go long and find it. And it's just a kind of a nice, slow, passive way to open up the hip flexor, psoas, after some of the other work we've done in the trap. And then, yogini's choice. If you just want to let yourself stay in this more restful position, you're welcome to, Nestoria. If you do want to come into shoulder stand or plow, or if you want to come into bridge or a different shape of that type, this is just an opportunity to let yourself kind of see if there's any other variations here. Last night when I was trying to fall asleep, I was listening to the Calm app, which I had just gotten, and it was Matthew McConaughey reading a book called One Day. And it's a sweet book. It's a story about a grandfather having a conversation with his granddaughter about the sky. But it was interesting because it was basically talking about how you can't worry about the future, because all you can really control right now is being in this particular moment. And basically, he just went around kind of getting your head going and thinking about right now there's a rainstorm happening, another place there's snow, another place it's dark, another place it's light. You know, there's birds flying, there's whales jumping, there's tigers running. There's people smiling, there's people eating, there's people sleeping. You know, just how many hundreds of millions of things are happening all
future, not the past, right now. So maybe right now, while you're here and just laying on the floor, let yourself be in this moment. Start to feel ready and start to bring in a wiggle in your fingers, a wiggle in your toes. Maybe it's a chance to stretch your arms and legs long, or maybe you're feeling more inclined to hug yourself into a little ball. And eventually you can let yourself just roll off to one side. You might pause there for a moment, just giving yourself a little squeeze. And eventually you can draw yourself up into comfortable seating. There's no rush, there's no hurry, just as it feels right for you. You can let your hands come into rest, just like coming at your heart, and whether they're in prayer or over your heart, whatever feels right for you. Just ending the practice with a metta prayer, which is a self-love prayer. And this is a version that I made up. You can always make up your own. It's may you be strong. May you feel safe, may you be happy, may you be healthy, and wherever you go and whatever you do, no one know that someone is thinking of you in this very moment, right now, with love in their hearts. Take a nice big inhale, exhale the sigh. Thank you, ladies. Thank you for coming to your mat here in person and also virtually. Together we'll say, namaste.
Hi Jen, how do you feel?